I am outside the president's hotel. We're reporting live here. Bill Hemmer is actually inside the same hotel as the president. I came out here because we started hearing this large crowd develop as word spread around Hanoi that President Trump would be staying at this hotel. I'm talking to people who say they've been waiting over 2 hours just to get a glimpse of President Trump. He actually went in sort of a back entrance, as you can imagine, for security reasons. And some of the Vietnamese folks behind me were just telling me during the break they want him to come out because they don't want to go home, they say, because they want to see him. A, they're very excited that the American president is in their country. And B, they say they're very excited about the prospect of peace, not just between the U.S. and North Korea. As you can hear some of the roaring out here and the flags out here, the people are waving Vietnamese flags as well. I want to talk to this young gentleman. He said he's 29 years old. You saw President Obama a few years ago in Vietnam. Why did you come out tonight?
Tonight, because some years ago I saw Mr. Obama, and this time I'm very happy because Mr. Trump come to Vietnam. Welcome, Mr. Trump.
How badly did you want to see him up close?
Want to see him?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm really want to see him.
What do you think about the chances of peace here with North Korea?
The peace with North Korea is because Mr. Trump is the people one, traditional people. So he will finish this shop with North Korea.
How long have you been waiting?
For 2 hours ago.
He's been waiting 2 hours. Thanks for talking to us. We appreciate it.
Yeah.
So, Sandra, it gives you an idea. There is a palpable excitement out here at A, the idea that the American president is now here, Kim Jong-un is now here in Hanoi, and the idea that there may actually be some peace. There's a lot of hard work that needs to be done, but there are people here from Vietnam, obviously, who saw their country racked by war for so long. They're excited, at least, about the prospect for peace, Sandra.